This is Zixit, a guy who has been trying to make such videos, and he did actually check Zixcam account. But there is always one spice missing, one little detail that shows he's just a beginner. And he was searching for that thing for over a year now, but he didn't find what he was searching for. Till he found this. Well, not exactly, cause he needed this also. So, let him cook his meal now.
So, I don't know, guys. I just came here to sit and watch what's going on around me and get ready to say what's my plan for the next month. As you guys know, I'm the guy that made a full video to say how miserable his life is. And I've been thinking about it lately. I want to make some videos. I put some goals to hit while keeping my notes as good as possible. Starting with this channel, Zixted. That started as a channel to throw uncompleted works and developed so fast to reach what it is now. I mean, yeah, you have seen my tutorials series. I know I talk about it so much, but hey, I'm proud of it. The next month, I will be sharing some videos on it, some basic videos until I finish my exams. Also, my channel with my friend Zixaro, which hasn't been launched yet, but yeah, we're planning to do some good videos in it.
So after you watch that part that was completely carved in DaVinci, it's time now to throw some facts. Well, in this part I will talk about my short experience with this app, and from now I didn't try the editing features in it. Let me know in the comments if you want me to do that. I will only talk about coloring, starting with number 1. I will compare DaVinci with Premiere cause it's the closest app to it,
and I hate Premiere.
As an Adobe user, in the first you will face some troubles trying to understand what's going on, but after some tutorials I found that the coloring UI in DaVinci is way better than Premiere. It just gave you everything without giving you everything. I'm shocked, to be honest, especially when I compare it to Premiere. I mean, when I use DaVinci, everything is responding fast and you don't really see any drop frame until you reach a point, which we will talk about it later. Unlike Premiere, Premiere, I don't really need to say anything about it. But when you reach a point where you are using the max of the app, it will cook your PC. I mean, do I need to say something in this part? Resolve is way better than Premiere in coloring. The fact that you have an app that offers you this amount of power and stuff for free, which we will talk about it later, is just amazing. I like how they are putting effort to develop this field, so definitely you have to switch to it if you want to take coloring seriously. DaVinci sells itself as a free program, the best, and I agree with that. It's by far the best free editing software. But as a guy who only tried coloring in it, I found myself using a lot of paid features and kind of rely on it. Also, a lot of tutorials online rely on the paid stuff, so I don't know. It's definitely better than Premiere. I mean, the paid version of DaVinci is just one-time purchase, unlike the monthly subscription of Premiere, but I had to mention it anyways. I won't say a lot in this part, but if you are used to the combination of Premiere and After, you will miss that here for obvious reasons. I don't know, but I found that DaVinci take more time in rendering comparing to Premiere. I searched about it online, but I didn't find a guide talking about it. So it may be a problem from my device. Overall, I consider this app as the goat of coloring, and I may give its editing part a try later. Let me know what do you think about this new style of videos, and be ready for some videos next month. Pray for me to pass my exams, and goodbye.